this program is vulnerable. And this really simplified program, what it's doing is something similar to what a password checking program might do. Think about what the program is doing. This is our main function. That's the program. It has take some arguments. It has a bunch of local variables. It has an integer that its value at the end is going to be should login be allowed or not allowed. It has a local variable of size no more than 12. That's where we're going to read the password that we're going to ask the user to type. And then we have to compare that with something that we know about the password of the user. So the target password here really is the password we're looking for. Here, this is a really poor practice here, but the target password is hard-coded. Other thing I should mention here is that password checking programs actually don't need to keep your password, because then if somebody gains control of that, then they know your password also. So these are sort of the local variables that we declared within this function. This is where we get to the code. The code is very simple. It's saying, I'm going to get a string. Get s is read a string function, get a string that you're going to type. We're going to read that string into this local variable password string that we declared. Then we're going to do a comparison of this string that we just read into pwdstr against our target password, which is my password 123. This string compare actually is this variant says at most 12 character long strings. And the result of this comparison, if the two strings are identical, then it returns a zero. Otherwise, it returns a non-zero value. So read more about this function to find out exactly what it returns in the other cases, less than zero or greater than zero. So in this case, allow login is set to one. After that, we're going to say if allow login is zero. Remember, that was the initial value. We assumed that we don't allow unless there is a match. Remember the fail-safe defaults we talked about? So the default here is don't allow. So that's why we're setting it to zero. So if the variable was not set to one as a result of a successful comparison, then it's still zero. And in that case, we're going to reject the login request. Otherwise, the match was successful. We set it to one. So in that case, we're going to allow the login request. But the goal here is to understand how vulnerable code gets exploited. So we want to see how this code gets exploited. And this simple program that we have here helps us do that.